You know, if there's one sentence I've never said here on the channel, that would simply be, I can't believe microtransactions did this much good. It gives me weird feelings in my stomach just saying it, so imagine me thinking it to speak it into this microphone. I want to just point one thing out, though. Last week, we made a video talking about the Outback Relief Pack and how Activision was actually going to release the number that was made from that pack being sold. And we now know that that number is $1.6 million for Australian wildfire efforts. This is very important. I'm glad that they did it. I wish it made more money. That's the first time I would ever say that about a microtransaction, by the way. But this just shows how much good can be done. And we know that Call of Duty already does the Call of Duty endowment, but I'd like to see them branch out and do other things. Even if it was just like once or twice a month, it'd be cool to see them go and support other causes like cancer research, the Humane Society, mental health research, children's hospitals, all different types of stuff. Obviously, there's so many different causes in this world, but it would be nice to see them branch out and start doing this a little bit more. You know, aside from their Call of Duty endowment that they do, it'd be nice to see other causes get into the mix as well. The 1.6 million is a huge number. That's a lot more than I thought it would be. I thought maybe 500,000 at max. That's what I had in my mind, but it really did surpass my expectations along with many other people's expectations. And even though this number is most likely inflated, specifically because there's a cause behind it, that's still a lot of money made from one single pack. Now, in my video from a few days ago, I said that it was going to be a little bit of a bittersweet moment. Sweet because obviously it's great that so much money was raised, and I wish more was raised. But bitter because now we're seeing the power behind a single pack. That's not to take away from the thunder. I still think it's a good thing. I just think that it's also important to keep our mind open on how many other packs exist at any given time. Now, if the number is inflated, what would we say that each pack would normally make without that? Answering this question really isn't so simple. Even with the number that we got from this single pack, I think that it all depends on what's in the pack as well. If there's a more flashy weapon or something that looks a lot better than normal, then there's more people probably inclined to purchase it. I would probably say that depending on the pack and what's in it, there's probably anywhere between $100,000 to $500,000 being made per pack. And if that's the case, that's a pretty decent amount of money. I mean, that's a lot of money. You got to consider there's like 10 to 15 packs in the shop at any given time. So there's multiple ways to get people to spend their money. And even if they're not getting that much money from one pack, they could be getting a lot more from another. For example, the most expensive pack that I've seen so far is the Gun Nut pack. And this has a bunch of blueprints in it. This one to me does not really jump out at me. This one, I don't like it. I think the price is too high. I think the weapons don't really look that interesting. And although I might not think it looks interesting, there could be somebody out there that actually loves the way that these weapons look and drop the $30 on it. That's why I'm saying like a pack like this may not get that much money, but it's still going to be making bank. Let's talk about a pack that ultimately probably made more money than the Outback Relief Pack. And that would be the Nikto Operator Bundle. I know it's a little bit cheap to go this route and say that this one made a lot of money, but you have to understand, it's still a pack. It's still money that they're making. This, to this very day, is the only way to get Nikto. This bundle also features different weapons that people actually want to use, like the Cerulean assault rifle that has blue tracer rounds and the Negotiation melee weapon that people will like to use in lieu of their standard combat knife. So a pack like this probably made well over $2 million, especially since this is the only way to get this particular character. What about a pack like this? Notice me. This is the anime waifu pack that we've talked about a few times here on the channel, and I'm sure you've seen it in my gameplay before. This is one of those packs that has a colorful weapon and a price that's a little more alluring to people. Instead of spending $20, you could spend $8 and you can get a nice weapon with a pretty interesting charm. I'm sure this one sold like hotcakes as well, specifically because of all the items that you get within the bundle. Anywho, that's pretty much all I wanted to talk about today. I know that this video really didn't have any direction. It was just really a follow-up video about the donations that were made through the Outback Relief Pack. I don't want it to seem like I'm taking the thunder away. I just want to put it into perspective that when there's limited time items, or limited time characters for that matter, these things are going to sell. I mean, they are going to sell and they're going to bring in a lot of money. The Nikto pack probably made well over $2 million or more. At least that's what I'm guessing, specifically because that's $24 times however many people wanted to get it. I bought Nikto. I wanted to play as that character. He's one of my favorite characters in this game to this very day. And until Ghost gets here, he's going to be my main go-to character when I play online. Anyway, guys, that's it. That's all I wanted to talk about. I hope that Activision moving forward does more of this. I'd really like them to put more support in other places. And I think it would be cool to raise money for other things. And the items that they put in it could be pretty sweet as well. Let me know what you guys think about it down below in the comment section. Sorry about my voice. I'm a little bit under the weather. I appreciate you coming out to today's video. Drop a like on it. Subscribe for more coming very soon. And don't forget to ring the bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. I'll catch you on the next one, guys. Peace.